Hey, hello. This is my second series on the topic communication. I've made the part one of communication where it includes basic forms of communication or what is communication and all. So in this second video, this is an extended version of communication. So let's start. Here we have channels of communication. What we will study today is channel of communication, interpersonal communication, interpersonal communication principles and functions, active listening and guidelines to effective listening. Okay, first, channel to communication. Channel or forms of communication. There can be various forms of communication. There can be formal communication, informal communication. Formal communication refers to all those communication where you need to talk to somebody professionally, on a professional basis. So that can be upward, downward, horizontal and diagonal. So if you want to go in detail that what is upward communication, what is downward communication, what is horizontal communication, what is diagonal communication, so let us understand. Upward communication is when you suppose this is our level, management level. This is top level management, this is middle level management, and this is low level management. Suppose this top level management, upward communication means when it goes from down to up. It means the middle level managers talk to top level managers, or low level managers talk to middle level managers. That is called upward communication, going in the opposite direction. This is upward communication. Whereas in the same sense, downward communication means when top level managers communicate to middle level managers or low level managers, or middle level managers communicated to low level managers, then it is called as downward communication. These are two types of formal communication. Then we have more two types, that is horizontal and diagonal. Horizontal means this, means in the same level, means two different departments managers communicating to each other, two top level managers communicating to each other, etc. Diagonal communication, when there is intercommunication between various departments or various levels of the organization, that is called diagonal communication. So we have informal communication, four types of communication: upward communication, downward communication, horizontal communication, diagonal communication. So after this four, we have some advantages of formal communication and some disadvantages of formal communication. Let us first study the advantages. The advantages are, it is a proper channel. Of course, there is a proper format or proper procedure through which you can communicate. For example, you need to complain in the organization regarding something. So you can communicate to the liaising officer or to a particular person where the person holds such complaint. So there is a proper channel. Second, better understanding. Of course, it usually formal communication is in written form. Either it can be through mails or letters to various departments. So it helps in better understanding. Third, it covers whole organization. Yes, if there is a communication which is given by top level management to middle levels or low levels, it covers the whole organization. So there is no scope of loopholes. Last is filtration of information. Yes. Information is filtered according to the needs. Top level managers make strategies for the whole organization and they communicate such strategies to various departments. And various departments only get that amount of information which is needed for the particular department, not for the whole organization. So filtration is done in this particular formal channel of communication. Next, the disadvantages. It is slow and rigid. Yes, of course. Whenever we do formal communication, it takes very long time. It is time consuming. It is very slowly. Top level manager will tell to the departmental heads. Departmental heads will tell to the supervisor. Then supervisor will communicate to the laborers or the workers. So it is a very rigid channel and it is very slow. Second, it is a narrow channel. Yes, sometimes filtration of information and choosing the particular audience where a particular person needs to communicate, it becomes a narrow channel. Third is it is expensive. Mostly it is written communication, so it becomes expensive. Last, it is time consuming. Yes, it consumes a lot of time. Now, we come to informal communication. There can be various types of informal communication. We are studying here is grapevine. Grapevine, the word grapevine is derived from a case. Actually, what happened was, in England, there were two buildings, two very big buildings. For example, this is a particular big building, and this is a particular building. And in olden times, what happened was, at that time, there was no mobile phones. So there were wired phones. It means telephone cables. So if two buildings need to communicate, they need to make wires and they need to communicate through this landline cables. So what happened was a grapefruit plant was developing, and that plant took all over these two poles. And there was all the grape plant all over here. So, due to the weight of such grape plant, this line or this wire was becoming heavy and was it was becoming heavy. So, when they talked on phone, this particular building people to this people and this people to this people, they cannot get their voices clearly. There were many confusions, many misunderstandings, particularly due to this wire. So that's why this communication is called grapevine communication. Grapevine communication usually means rumors which is spread in an organization very fastly, and it is usually considered as the half truth. There is no particular full truth in grapevine communication. So grapevine communication is usually rumor form, and it has no valid proof that the particular information is true or not. So, advantages. It is free form of communication. Rumors can be spread by any person in the organization. So, of course, it can travel from top level, middle level, low level, anywhere in the organization. Second, it is quick and fast. Yes, it is very fast. People tend to gossip more as compared to communicate. So, of course, it is faster as compared to formal communication. Third, there is no rigid channel. Anybody can gossip about any person in the whole organization. So there is no particular channel that it will flow from top level to bottom level or bottom level to top level. It can flow from any person to any department. Disadvantages. It is half truth, of course. It is not the total truth. It is the rumor spread by individuals. Second, misinformed. Yes, miscommunication can be done. Third, organization image gets spoiled. Yes, if there are many rumors inside the organization about the particular organization, its image gets destroyed. These are the various channels of communication. Now, let's go to interpersonal communication. Interpersonal communication is nothing but communication between two persons who want to come closer and build relations with each other for better understanding. For example, friends. We make friends on the basis of our choice. Why do we make a particular person our best friend? Because his likes or my like can be same. That's why it is called as interpersonal communication. So let us understand the definition. Not only communication or communicate information, but also to build close relations and understanding. The principles of these interpersonal communication are inescapable, irreversible, complicated, and contextual. Two persons sitting in a particular room, it is impossible that they don't communicate. So it is inescapable form of communication. It is irreversible. Once you said, you cannot take it back. It is complicated. Yes, of course. When you talk too much about your feelings or your life, it becomes complicated for the other person to understand. And so, contextual. It includes various matters. It can be your personal life, your professional life, anything, etc. The functions. The functions of interpersonal communication are gaining information about the other person, yes, of course, building understanding between the two persons, establishing identity of a particular person, and interpersonal needs. Some people like to talk about their problems, some people don't like to talk about their problems. So interpersonal needs get satisfied if a particular person needs to talk on a particular topic or on a particular problem of his or her. Now this last topic of today, active listening. What do you mean by active listening? There is a difference between hearing and listening. Hearing is only through ears. It means that a particular person is going on telling and you're just hearing, you're not taking that particular thing in your mind, you're not understanding it. But when you understand it through your mind, that is called listening. There is a big difference between hearing and listening. Everybody hears, but only few listens. So how can you listen to a particular topic? Sometimes it happens when you're in a particular classroom and when there is a lecture going on, the ma'am or the sir, whatever he's teaching, you are just listening to it. Sorry, you are just hearing to it. You are not listening. So you are there mentally, you are there physically, but mentally you are somewhere else. You are daydreaming. You are thinking about your future. You are making plans about movie or etc. So that is hearing. That is not listening. Listening is when you sit at a particular place, a person, whatever he is telling or whatever word he is using, you know the meaning, you are understanding it thoroughly. So that is called listening. So the guidelines of effective listening are: avoid distractions. If there is any distraction, your mobile is vibrating or there are notifications in your mobile, keep your mobile aside. That is very important. Second, maintain eye contact. The person who is communicating to you, if he is physically present, maintain eye contact with the person so that you can understand. And that particular person understands that you are listening to that particular person. Take notes whenever needed. Whenever you think that this point I need to note it down, please take notes. Fourth, take keen interest. Take very good interest in that particular topic. Keep mind active. Don't stop daydreaming, stop thinking here and there, stop distracting yourself. Third, avoid whispering. Avoid talking to your neighbor or someone else at the same point of time. Observe elements of communication like body language, movements, gestures, postures, etc. These are the guidelines for effective listening. So let me give a quick recap of today what we have learned. Channels of communication. There are two channels of communication: formal and informal. In formal, we have upward, downward, horizontal, diagonal, and in informal, we have grapevine. There are some advantages and disadvantages of formal and as well as informal communication. Now we have interpersonal communication. Interpersonal communication means when two or more persons communicate with each other, not only for the purpose of communication but also for the purpose of building relations and understanding, then it is called as interpersonal communication. Then we have gone to active listening. Active listening means listening through the mind, understanding each and every aspect of what you hear. The last but not the least is guidelines of effective communication. These are the few points which, if you consider, you can listen effectively. Thank you. If you have any doubts regarding this particular topic of today, please mention in the comment section below. And thank you for watching. Thank you for patient listening. And please do subscribe. Thank you.